In this video, I want to talk real quick about thread specification, specifically depth of the full thread and depth of the tap drill. We've got simple block, right? I'm just trying to show you that there's a threaded hole. Here's our thread callout, which doesn't really matter much for our example, but it's a half inch 13 thread. Here is one way to call out the thread depth. So I'm talking about this, the depth of the full thread. So if you threaded something in there, it would go at least that far. And then the depth of the tap drill, which is to this shoulder right here. The first way I've shown it, there is no tolerance given with the information, right? So we're saying half inch for the full thread, 0.75 or 3/4 inch for the tap drill. In order to get a tolerance for that, and yes, it does have a tolerance, all dimensions have a tolerance, we'll go to our title block, okay? Now, this is where this system can kind of break down, because if you're not paying attention, you might have three decimal places here, in which most companies would have plus or minus 5 thousandths. In this case, I've given it as 2 decimal places, or plus or minus 20, which is more reasonable to achieve, but you think about what you're doing, you're specifying that there's a range in which the full thread must be and the range in which the tap drill must be, which isn't the end of the world, but there is a better way to do it. And that better way is to specify the minimum full thread and the maximum tap drill. In this way, you're getting away from the plus or the minus, this range of places the thread and the tap drill can be, and giving a functional requirement. So how does it work? When we say half inch minimum thread, it means we could thread it all the way to the bottom. Now, most shops aren't going to do that because it's very difficult, but if they did, it doesn't change the design in almost any case that I can think of. If you threaded it all the way to the bottom of the hole, you're going to thread a fastener in there and it won't affect anything. If they only threaded 1/4 inch and you have a half inch threaded fastener, right, it's going to stop somewhere. So threading further generally isn't going to hurt the functionality of your design. Although manufacturability, right, you're generally going to aim for this half inch mark, maybe a little bit past it. The 0.75 or 3/4 max tap drill, the same idea here. If you wanted to tap it to a half inch and drill, well, of course you drill it first, but if you want to drill to say 0.6 and tap to 1/100 thousandths near the bottom of that, you could. You wouldn't want to, manufacturability. You want to have as much room as you can, but it is possible. So say you're running production and for whatever reason, you're not drilling far enough. As long as you can tap to the bottom of the drilled hole, you're good to go. So it just gives you flexibility. I mean, there's 1/4 inch between these where you have a range that either the thread can use or the tap drill can use, as opposed to kind of artificially limiting them in a way that really isn't functional in any way. Now, the last thing I want to cover, we talked about the tap drill going to the shoulder. You got to figure out, what drill bit you're using to see if the point is going to punch through the bottom of the part. Now, a common thing you'll see on drawings is do not break through. Now, sometimes there's a legitimate reason for this. Maybe it is something that's difficult to calculate. Oftentimes, or sometimes, it's because the designer was essentially taking a shortcut. They may totally omit that dimension and just say, hey, here's the minimum thread and tap as deep as you want, but don't break through. In this case, whether we left the 0.75 or not, there is a limit to how far you can tap that hole. So it can lead to situations where you're looking at the drawing and you're saying, okay, 3/4 inch, you go to run your tap drill and you punch through the bottom of the part. So I'd just say beware when you see do not break through. It means there might be, the designer only calculated it to here and didn't, run any calculations to see what the drill point is going to do. Of course, there's more to threads than this, but I've seen it a whole lot where you see a thread call out with the linear dimension. Normally it don't have a plus or minus, so it goes to title block, and it can create an issue. Now you might say, well, we don't check that, right? We just assume our tooling does it correctly. I mean, that's fine, you know, if you don't want to check stuff, but you really want to live in a world where the specification matches the functional requirement and is simple enough to check. So that's the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe, leave a comment down below.